Welcome to everyone. Today, let us look at lesson 2 of grade 8 geography, land, soil, water, natural vegetation, and wildlife. Before we get into the details of the chapter, let us first look at the learning objectives of this chapter. The students will be able to explain and define the importance of the natural resources such as land, soil, water, and natural vegetation. So once students hear to the lectures of this lesson, they should be able to explain and define what is the importance of the natural resources such as land, soil, water, and natural vegetation. Then the second learning objective is that they should be able to compare and evaluate the need for the careful usage of resources like water in India and other countries in the world. Then, further, they will be also able to discuss the need for the conservation of natural vegetation and wildlife forests, which are our wealth bank. Let us look at the subtopics in this chapter. The subtopics in this chapter are quite a few. So, land and land use, conservation of land resource, soil and landslides, and also we study about soil profile, factors of soil formation, degradation of the soil, and what are the measures that have to be taken for conservation of soil, water, problems of water availability, conservation of water resources. Then we move on to natural vegetation and wildlife, distribution of natural vegetation, conservation of natural vegetation and wildlife forests, which are our wealth banks. So these are the subtopics what we are going to look in this chapter in detail. Now let us move to the first topic, that is land. Land is among the most important natural resources what we have. Among all the natural resources, land plays a very important role. Why? Because land is the only sphere where we all survive. It covers only about 30% of the total area of the earth's surface, and among that it is again divided into parts of this small percentage are not habitable. So it is only about 30% of the entire total area. We all know 70% of the earth is covered with water, roughly 71%. So remaining small parts of the land, whichever is there, that is not habitable, which cannot be used for habitat. The uneven distribution of the population in different parts of the world is mainly due to the varied characteristics of land and climate. Today, we find lot of population in some areas in Asia, where hugely populated countries are there, while in some areas in North America or in South America or in Europe, you don't find so thickly populated places. These all variations in the distribution of population are the characteristics of land and its climatic effects. So what I want to tell you here is the population living in large density is one of the byproduct of the characteristics of land and climate. So basing on the land and the climate, the population density will be either increasing or decreasing. The rugged topography, the steep slopes of the mountains, low-lying areas susceptible to water logging, desert areas, thick forest areas are normally fairly populated or uninhabited areas. So the rugged topography, the uneven topography, the steep slopes of the mountains, the low-lying areas which are susceptible or accessible to waterlogging, desert areas or the thick forest areas are normally unpopulated areas or not highly populated areas. You find very little population living here. The meaning here is, because of the varied characteristics of land and climate, the topography, the mountains, the waterlogging areas, the desert areas, and the forest areas are not preferred by large population to stay. People would love to stay in the places like plain, river valley regions, which are suitable for agriculture. Hence, these are the places which are densely populated areas of the world. So, basing on the land, we can know how the population is being distributed. Land is one of the important resources which is covering nearly 30% of the total area of the earth's surface, and some small minute portions which are like islands and all are not useful for habitat. The uneven distribution of population in different parts of the world is mainly due to the varied characteristics of land and climate. The places which have more densely populated regions are plains and river valleys. Now let us move on to find out what are the uses of land. How do we use the land? Land is used for different purposes. As we discussed in the previous session, that it is used for agriculture, forestry, mining, building houses, roads, and setting up of industries. This is commonly termed as land use. How do we use land? Land can be used for different purposes, such as agriculture, forestry, mining, building houses, roads, and setting up of industries. This is commonly termed as land use. Can you list out the different ways in which Mambas and Peters family use their land? This is a case study which is given in your textbook. So for your reference, I am giving you the key points from that also. The use of land is determined by the physical factors such as topography, soil, climate, minerals, and availability of water. So what are the factors that determine the usage of the land? The factors that determine the usage of the land are 5. They are topography, soil, climate, minerals, and availability of water. Human factors such as population and technology are also important determinants of land use pattern. What are the human factors that influence the land use pattern? The important human factors which determine the usage of land are population and technology. How can be land classified? Land can be classified on the basis of ownership into two groups. One is private land and second one is community land. The land can be classified into two groups basing on the ownership of the land. One is the private lands, the other one is the community lands. What are private lands? The private land is a land which is owned by an individual whereas community land is the one which is owned by a community for the common uses like collection of fodder, fruits, nuts or medicinal herbs. Private land is owned by an individual. Community land is owned by a community. The community lands are also called as common property resources. What is the other name for the community lands? Common property resources. The quality of the land also differs from place to place. People and their demands are ever growing, but the availability of the land is really limited. As we studied, it is only 30% of the land area occupied on the earth's percentage. So the quality of the land differs from place to place. People started encroaching the common lands to build up commercial areas, housing complex in the urban areas, and to expand the agricultural lands in the rural areas. So people, the population is increasing day to day, but the availability of the land is limited. That is one reason why we have huge demand for land. And also, the quality of land differs from place to place. People now started encroaching the common lands to build up the commercial areas, the housing complexes in the urban areas, and to expand the agricultural land in the rural areas. Today, the vast changes in the land use patterns also reflect the cultural changes in our society. Due to the change in the usage of the land pattern, that is also reflecting in the cultural changes in our society. The land degradation, landslides, soil erosion, desertification are the major threats to the environment because of the expansion of agriculture and construction activities. There are few problems which are there due to the expansion of agriculture and the increase of construction activity. They are land degradation, landslides, soil erosion, and desertification are a few problems which are arising due to the expansion of agriculture and construction activity. Conservation of land resources. The growing population and their ever-growing demand has led to a large-scale destruction of forest cover and arable lands and has created a fear of losing this natural resource. Due to the growth in the population and the demand for the growth of the land has led to destruction of forest cover and the arable lands, which created a lot of fear and threat of losing this natural resource. Therefore, the present rate of degradation of land must be checked. Afforestation, land reclamation, regulated use of chemical pesticides and fertilizers, and check on grazing or overgrazing are some of the common methods which can be used to conserve land resources. We need to have afforestation in place, land reclamation, regulated usage of chemical pesticides and fertilizers, and check on overgrazing are some of the common methods that can be used to conserve land resources. So in this session, we looked at the learning objectives of this chapter, the first part. Then we moved on to understand the topic web, that is the subtopic which are going to be dealt in this chapter. Then we moved on to understand the importance of land as a resource. How much percentage of land do we have? How does it is directly linked with the population density? Then we learned about how to use the land. What is the meaning of the word land use? The difference between the private lands and the community lands. We also studied about the methods or the threats due to expansion of agriculture and construction activities. Then finally we discussed about the steps that have to be taken for the conservation of land as a resource. That's all we have in this session. Stay tuned. We'll catch you in the next session.